everybody. Hi, everybody. I'm Boris from Wix. And today, I want us to have a look at the following job posting for a front-end developer position. Now, usually the purpose of the job posting is to describe to the world how does the ideal candidate look like, right? And we will have a closer look. Oh, there is a delay. We will notice that the requirements are dominated by the amount of tools and frameworks we want the candidate to be familiar with. And I'm sure this is probably familiar to most of you, because this is what most job postings look like today. And today, I'm here to convince you that these job postings are a form of self-inflicted damage, because they have a potential of attracting a bunch of assholes to your company that will ruin your culture and damage the quality of your product. So who are these assholes? Well, these are what's called CV-driven developers. And what's a CV-driven development? Well, it's a software development practice, there's actually a definition, where the developer, makes his decisions primarily of how it will affect his resume, no matter how irrational these decisions actually are. So what's wrong with that, right? Well, first of all, let's imagine the, how would we conduct an interview with such a person? So we will spend most of our time trying to actually figure out how familiar this person is with different tools and frameworks that we have listed, instead of actually trying to figure out how good of a developer he really is. And just imagine if we have one CDD conducting an interview to another CDD. So, assuming that you have hired that person, what your company will encounter is what's called a principal agent problem. Now, a principal agent problem is when a principal, in our case, a company, hires an agent, in our case, a developer, to perform a certain task on its behalf. Now, the problem arises when the agent decides to act in his own self-interest, which contradicts the interest of the company, okay? Now, the interest of the company is, of course, to grow, to become successful, and to bring as much value as possible to its users. But that shit doesn't interest the CDD, right? He's not interested in all that. What he's interested in is bring as many tools as possible into the company stack at any cost, even if that means damaging its velocity and the quality of the product. And when the CDD succeeds and gets his wishes granted, he proceeds to write horrible, fragile, unmaintainable code. Why? Well, it's easy. Because the CDD doesn't spend his time learning about scalable architectures and clean code. He spends his time learning yet another amazing new library. Oh, but guess what? Your users get to join the party as well, because now, each time they will try to use your product, they have yet another amazing library to download, leading us to crap like that. Now, yeah, guess what? But it doesn't end there. Because now it's time for the great rewrite pitch. AKA, well, I know our code base sucks, but it's not because of the developers. The stack is the one to blame. And if only we could use this amazing new framework that was released yesterday and has 10,000 open issues on GitHub, it will all be better. But folks, I'm here to tell you today that it almost never is. And like, why would it be? The CDD does not spend time questioning previously made decisions, trying to find flaws in the existing design. The CDD does not design, because in his mind, the tools will provide the answer, right? And even if the rewrite is to happen, he will not choose the tools that are right for the job. He will actually choose the tools that are right for him. So how can we prevent CV-driven development? Well, I think we as an industry need to reiterate our focus on code quality and engineering skills by demanding it from our candidates. We must move SAS and Redux and all that crap to the nice-to-have section of the job description. We must focus on stuff like solid principles instead of React. We must focus on clean code instead of Webpack, which is awesome, but still. Well, but then you may say, well, screw that. That means I will spend my time doing the HR's job. I will spend my whole day filtering resumes, conducting phone interviews. Well, not necessarily. Because it's true that the HR's job will become more difficult. Filtering by keywords may no longer work. But if you think about it, it's a simple cause and effect. The CV's contents are directly impacted by the requirements we as employers are putting out there. So if you will change the latter, the former will change as well and will contain all the information you need to make the right decision. And then naturally, the next step would be to educate and to work with your recruiters and your HRs. Well, but then you may say, well, who will even want to work for me? How will I even hire? This is what people want. People want to use new shit. They want to join companies to learn the most cutting-edge tech. But I think if that's the case, we should ask ourselves why. Why is this what the developers are looking for in their next employer? And I think the answer is pretty easy. Because we made them to. Because by putting out job postings like the one we've seen earlier, we are creating an illusion that learning as many libraries as possible is the only way to advance your career as a developer. Right? So I'm here to suggest that perhaps instead of marketing your company as a company you join to learn new frameworks, why don't instead you market your company as a place you join to become a better developer, to become a better software engineer, to hone your software craftsmanship skills? Now, it's true that they may scare off some people. That's true. But let me ask you a question. Are people whose primary focus in life is wrapping React.js with Vue.js instead of building a quality product, are people worth crying over? Thank you.